going to waste because when they are not in a position to understand me, whatever they think, whatever they wish, whatever the action they do, whatever with what knowledge they do, all these are going to be waste because they are adopting this evilish or devilish nature and the undivine nature. Rakshasim asurim chaiva. Rakshasim asur, rakshasim means devilish nature. Asurim chaiva means undivine nature. Prakritim mohini smritaha. Because they are under the influence of this nature, naturally they will disrespect me. That's why Mahanatum Mahatmanastu Mam Partha Daivim Prakritamasita Bhajan Chananyamanaso Jnatva Bhutadi Mavyayam. The great souls who are born in the divine nature. Here in Bhagavad Gita, Paramatma is always demarcating between the people who are having this Daivi Prakriti and Asuri Prakriti. Daivi Prakriti means divine nature, Asuri Prakriti means undivine nature. Their qualities and their behavior, their understanding, their efforts will be always different. In this way, Mahatmanastu Mam Partha Daivim Prakrutimartha Asritaha. The people who are having this divine nature, they are called great souls, they are Mahatmas. Daivim Prakriti Bhajan Chanyamanaso Jnatva. They will always pray me within them only. Anyam means other than the other than you. Ananyam means within yourself. Bhajanti ananya manaso jnatva bhotam adi avyayam. They know pretty well that I am the starting point of all this creation and they will pray me within themselves. Bhajan chananya manaso jnatva bhotam adi avyayam. I am always imperishable and I am the initiator at the starting point of this creation. Like that they know me, about me, and they will worship me within themselves. They are called these Daivi Sampada people, the people of divine nature. They will be praying like that. How they will pray, I will tell you. Satatam kirtayantoma yatantascha dhruvrataha namasyantascha mam nitya bhakya nityukta upasate. They will be going on worshipping me like this. Satatam kirtayantoma, they will be going on glorifying me. They will chant me, they will praise me, they will do all sorts of devotional acts. And with devotion, with steadfast vow, by doing vratas, constant stubborn will, they will be going on doing this effort. Mind you, all these efforts are within himself only. That is the difference between the people who are doing worship to deities and the persons with divine nature worshipping within themselves. So this is satatam kirtayanto mam bhajanta mam dhruvrataha namasyanta mam nityam. They will be going on prostrating. They will, whatever they do, they will feel within themselves. Nichyukta upasate. Yukta means yukta ichyuchyate. Never forget that whatever Paramatma says within means by doing yoga only. Why? Because without the help of this prana shakti, nobody can keep this mind within the Paramatma, Paramatma who is dwelling within themselves. So to keep his mind, you have to keep his life force also. Wherever Paramatma says means, he has to do yoga. ज्ञान यज्ञेन चैप्यन्य यजंतो मा उपासते एकत्वेन पृथग्वेन बहुधा विशतो मुखम. Some people with in the form of a jnana yajnam. Here also jnana yajnam means not simply by mental thinking. They are also advanced people who are already done this yogam and their main brain has matured. They will pray me like this. Jnana yajnam chepyanye yajanto mam upasate. They will also be worship me, but they will be praying me in two ways. Ekatvena, prudhakvena, bahudha visvato mukham. Some people, they will think that I am a single entity who is dwelling everywhere. So wherever she sees that I am a single entity existing in everywhere. ekatvayan pradatvayan. Some people they think that whatever we see it is the meaning is same, but in diverse fashion whatever the shape they see outside, but thinking inside they will feel that I am alone, I am only single entity, I am the universal paramatma. So jnana yajnana chaitanyam bahudha visudham jnana yajnana chaitanyam ajanto ma upasate ekatvena pradagvena bahudha visudham. Till now I told about the people who are having this divine nature, they will be praying within themselves. Now the people who are praying outside, I will tell you aham krutur aham yajnam swada aham aham aushadam mantroham aham evajyam aham agni aham hutam. The people who are praying outside, they will be feeling like this. That is aham kratu, I am the yagam, aham yajnam, I am the sacrifice, aham swadaham. Swadaham means there is a food served in the worshipping the pitrudevatas, that is called swadaham. Swadaham, that is a sort of food. That means food is nothing but the flour and mixed with the other honey, this ghee and all these mixed with, that is called swadhama. Tilatandula mashancha chadamadi samanvatam sarpisa parushoshancha pura purodavasam itisputaha. So all these combined together, that is called swadhama, that is offered during the pitrutarpanam, when they are offering to the incest father, that is called swadhama. That is also I am, aham aushadam, I am the medicinal plants and the herbs also. So everywhere I am. So here aham kratum aham yajnam swada aham aham aushadam mantroham ahamevajyam, I am mantram also, aham ajyam, I means here ghee, the ghee also, aham agni aham hutam, I am fire also, and I am also the offering which are offering into the yajnahomam, yajnagundam. So all these are I am only. Whatever they do, I am that only. Pitaham ahamasya jagatah mata dhata pitamaha vejyam pavitra munkaraha ruksama yajarevacha. Here also is Paramatma is telling that pitaham ahamasya, I am father and mother, and the creator, the pitamaha is Brahman. I am the creator who is the pitamaha, I am the father and the mother also. Vejyam pavitra omkaraha, you know that this pious omkaram is not a separate one, but it is the yoga sadhana only. So that is there in every vedam. Ruksama yajurevacha, drugvedam, yajurvedam and samavedam also. In most of the contexts, only three Vedas, Ruksama, Yajur Vedas are mentioned, but leaving the Atharvana Vedam. Atharvana Vedam is also Vedam, but it is practically dealing with the mechanics, that is physical way. That's why most of the people, they don't take this into consideration. So this leaving this Atharvana Vedam only, in ancient days, most of the foreigners, including Germany and Russians and other people, they have taken with the Adharvedam, where every mechanical powers are there in that Adharvedam. Now they are taken it out, exhibited out, and they are more advantageous than us. That's why this Adharvedam is also now important. Yajam pavitra munkaru ruksama yajarevacha. Ruksama yajarevacha. अहम गतिर्भक्त प्रभुसाक्षी निवास शरण शरण सुहृत् प्रभव प्रलयस्थान निधान बीजम व्ययम. यू अंडरस्टैंड दट ऐ आम गति, दट ईज दि गोल, भक्त दट मीन्स दि प्रोटेक्टर, प्रभु ऐ एम दि लॉर्ड, साक्षी ऐ एम दि फिटनेस, निवास ऐ एम दि एबोर्ड, शरण ऐ एम दि शेल्टर, एंड सुहृत् ऐ एम दि friend, but without any return. There will be two varieties of friends. One friend is a mutual friend, the other friend is suhurt, means he will going on helping others only, but without aspiring for any in return. So I am suhurt prabhava pralayasthanam. I am the seat for this creation, and pralayasthanam, it is, I am the seat where the entire creation dissolves. Nidanam nivasa nidanam nidanam prabhav pralasthanam nivasam nidanam bijam avyam. That means I am the treasure house, whatever the possessions the creature, the all this having, I am the treasure house. Bijam, I am the seed, I am unperishable, imperishable. So all these are my qualities. I am staying everywhere. Tapami aham varsham, tapamyaham aham varsham visrusya visrujamcha nigruhta visrujamcha. Here also I am both heat and cold. I am the summer, I am the rain, I am everything. If I withdraw, there will be famine, there will be drought. If I think, there will be floods. So whatever the extremities, natural calamities also are there, they are with my sankalpam only, with my sankalpam only. But I am not there to pay, not to harm them, but depending upon their nature only, my nature will be behaving like that. That my nature will be reacting according to their nature, because when they neglect me, naturally my nature will pounce upon them. So like that, tapami tapamyaham aham varsham, I am both heat and rain. Nigruhsya visrujamcha, I can withdraw the rain and I can also overflow the rain. Like that, amrutancha mrutyuscha sadasad uchyate anna. That means amrutanchaiva, that means I am the immortal. That is, you can take in two meanings. That is, I am immortal, and at the same time, the sadhakas, I am the ambrosia or the nectar, and death also. So amrutanchaiva mrutyuscha sadasatchaham arjuna. Here I am both sat and asat. That means perishable and imperishable. So whatever the material or immaterial is there in the entire creation, I am that only. So all these are in different forms, I am existing, and the people who cannot understand me properly, they will be going on doing some worship outside. How they will worship, I will tell you. Trivijya somapa potapapa rajya rishpa swargatim prardhayante te punyamasajya surendra loka masranti divyan divideva bhogan. In this way, the people who are praying outside other than me, when they pray outside other than their heart, they will be praying like that. Trivijya somapa, that means they will do all these sacrifices, yajnas, which are there in Ruk, Sama, Yajurvedas, Potapa, Somapaha. Somapa means they will be drinking some somarasam, that is there in, available in the Himalayas also. That is called somarasam. They will be drinking, thinking that if they drink, they will be burning all their sins, and they will get to heaven and all these things. So trivijya somapa potapapa yajya rishpa swargatim prardhayante, they will be going on worshipping and praying me to get entry into the heaven. After doing all these rituals, all these external karmas, they will be attaining some virtue, they will get some punyam. With that punyam, they will come to the heaven, where they will be enjoying for a longer period. For a longer period, all day they will enjoy all the comforts. So trivijya somapa potapapa yajna rishtva swargatim prardhayante te punyam asajya surendra lokam asyante. They will wish the surendra lokam, that means the heaven, in that Indra is the master, so they will want to get that Indra Padavi also. Surendra Lakmas, Divyan, Divideva Bhagan, they will be going on enjoying these all these heavenly comforts. Tetam Bhunta Swarga Swargalokam Vishalam Shine Punye Matyalokam Vasanti. This is the very cautioning slokam for every man who is doing this all these external karmas, leaving me where I am dwelling within your heart. When you are leaving me within your heart and doing outside, the ultimate result is like this. Tetam bhuntva swargalokam vishalam. After enjoying the vast heaven after for a longer period, shine punye marchalokam visanti. After exhausting all this punyam, they will again come to the mortal worlds. Mortal worlds means not only coming into the human world, but they may be going to lower worlds also. Imam lokam hinataramva visanti. In the Mundakopanishad it says, after exhaustion of this punyam in the heaven, they will be thrown into the human world. Machilokam means that which perishes downward, that is either be human form or they will go to lower births also. Chine punye machilokam visanti evam trayi dharma anuprapanna gatagatam kamakama labhante. So their fate is like that. By going upwards, by doing some rituals, they will go to heaven, and after that they will come down again, they will do something and again go upwards. Like that they will be going on up and down. By going up and down, you will be ultimately facing this birth and death cycle. If you do up and down, you will get rid of this birth and death cycle, that is pranayama. So going up and down is only whether it is internal or external. If you do external outside, going up and down, you will have to face the permanent misery. But if you do it up and down inside, you will get away from this. That is the main difference between a yogi and non-yogi. In that way, now he is going to mention, ananiyas chintayintomam yejana paripasate tesham nityabhyuktanam yogakshemam vahamyaham. Ananiyas chintayintomam, again I am telling, anya means other than you, ananya means within you. Ananiyas chintayintomam, those who pray me within themselves. Ananya chintayanto mam yajana paryupasate, those who worship me thoroughly me, I will take care of them. Yogakshemam vahamyaham. Here yogakshemam means I will take care of their yogam. Yogam means aprapya prapanam yogaha. Whatever the thing which is to be known, that is the brahmajnana, that is Brahman, that will be achieved by doing yogam. That is called aprapya propanam yogam. That blessing by which the yogam will be increased, that is called yogam. Kshemam means that already got it and that will be protected. Kshemam tad rakshana evacha, by protecting what already got accomplished, that will be protected. With these two words, Paramatma is telling that I will take care of their yogam kshemam. Here, in the second chapter, Paramatma already told that Traigunya Vishaya Veda Nistraigunyo Bhavarjuna Nirdvandho Nichasattvastho Niryoga Kshema Atmavan. In that, you get away from the external Veda karmas and don't worry about your own Yoga Kshema. Yoga Kshema means to protect your body and the samsaram and this worldly ambition. Don't try to get these things. I will take care of if you do this yogam. Here now he is assuring that I will take that your yogam and kshemam. With this, in this slokam, there is a beautiful story told by our Gurudev, Brahmarshi, Sadguru Sri 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 Swami Ramananda Paramahansa, his own experience. He used to tell me one story. When our Swamiji is in his initial days of sannyasam, when he took sannyasam at Vijayanagaram, when he is returning from Vijayanagaram to Vijayawada, on the way at one place called Elamanchali. At that is the main road of this GT road. There is one place, city called Elamanchali. By the side of the main road at Elamanchali, Swamiji was following with other sannyasins also initially. He was following with the other sannyasins also. Like that, he used to go to the villages and beg for the food, bhiksha. Like that, he was following. When he has gone to that village, main road of that Elamanchali, he saw one well with a bucket. After seeing that bucket and that well, he asked the other sannyasins to, "You please leave me, you go away, I will remain here, I will take bath and do yogam." He is the only person who was doing yogam, rest of the peoples are non-yogis. But unfortunately, he was supposed to mingle with the other sannyasins. Like that, he got separated and he started doing this pranayama. By the side of this main road, he took asanam at one, he took bath and did pranayama at the one under the shade of a tree. When he was doing this pranayama, a person native of this Elamanchali village, he was observing behind him. When he was observing, after 2 hours, Swamiji got up, and when he got up, that person immediately ran to him and prostrated before Swamiji and asked Swamiji, "Swamiji, please come to my house. I will give bhiksha. I am offering you bhiksha. Please accept my bhiksha." He has prayed like that. Even then also, Swamiji had refused. I don't want to come. I don't know where is your house. I don't come. Like that, he replied. But politely, that person again prayed him, "Swamiji, don't worry. At the time of bhiksha, that is about 12 noon, I will personally come and take you to my house and serve you food." Then reluctantly, he agreed. All right. And after that also, again, Swamiji sat up in yogam. He did some more hours also. So he did for 2 more hours, and after 12, when he got up, the person took him to his house and served food. When Swamiji had finished the bhiksha, on the same street of that Elamanchali village, the rest of the swamins, rest of the sannyasins who were till now coming with him, they were searching for food. They didn't get food. They didn't get food. But Swamiji did this yogam and got food. And then he thought that Ananya Chintayantomam Yajana Paripasate Tesham Nityabhyaktanam Yogakshemam Vahamiham. So I have to underline this slokam, Yogakshemam Vahamiham. Swamiji used to say us like this: when you do your duty, definitely God will do his duty. Because I did my duty by doing yogam, so God also did his duty by giving food to me. So this is the story behind, told by our Swamiji. So like that, any seeker, first he has to do his duty first by praying God by doing yogam, then only God will look after everything. That is the essence of this slokam, Yoga Kshemam Vahamyaham. Of course, unfortunately, we are now facing so many untoward and these calamities. But immediately, we can't say that these people are responsible for all these things. But there must be some reason behind this. But that reason is nothing but the people who have never prayed God in the previous births also, because of that only the situation has come. So we need not blame anybody, but the situation is like that. We have to understand that when you neglect God, definitely he will neglect. He will become a witness only. Ananya Chintayantoma Yajana Paripasate Tesha Nichabhyuktanam Yogakshemam Vahamyaham. ये प्यन्यदेवता भक्ता यजन्ते श्रद्धयान्विताः तेपि मामेव कौन्तेय यजन् च विधिपूर्वकम्. परमात्मा इज अगेन स्ट्रेसिंग दट some people, even they are having utmost faith and confidence over me, but they don't know how to approach me. Simply, they will be praying other deities outside their heart. When they pray the new karmas outside, pray deities, but they are also bhaktas. Ye pranya devata bhakta yajante mam sraddhayanata. They have got sraddha, but they are doing worship in a wrong way. Yajant avidhi purvakam, but they are not proceeding systematically. That means they are doing outside prayer. See the difference between the people who are doing worshipping within themselves and worshipping outside themselves. He is now going to contrast these things. ये प्यन्यदेवता यजन्ते माम श्रद्धयान्विता तेपि मामेव कौन्ते यजन् चविधिपूर्वकम् बट दे आर प्रोसीडिंग इन ए रॉन्ग डायरेक्शन वाट इज देयर फेट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अहम स सर्वे यज्ञानां भोक्ता च प्रभुरेव च न तु माम अभिजानन्ति अतत्ये चवन्ति ते हियर ही इज क्लियरली मेंशनिंग दिस श्लोक आल्सो वन शुड अंडरस्टैंड That means, aham si sarvajnanam, aham si sarvajnanam, I am the bhakta cha prabhureva cha, I am the enjoyer and the lord of all these sacrifices, whether you do inside or outside, I am the bhakta, I am the enjoyer of all these things. Aham si sarvajnanam, bhakta cha prabhureva cha, natumam abhijananti, atat chavanti te, Natumam abhijanante, but they don't know me, they cannot understand me. Atatte chavantate, that means ultimately they will fall down. So even though they are having sraddha and bhakti, but doing in a wrong way, other systematically they are doing, naturally they will be fall down. Falling down means by getting births and deaths. Natumam abhijananti etat. Atat yetat chavantite, they will be falling down. So, the person who are worshipping within himself and outside, again he is telling, Jyanti devratan devan pitrunyanti pitrutaha bhuteri yanti bhuteja yanti yajyapivam. Like that, the yanti devratan yanti, those who are worshipping devatas, they will get devatas. Pitrunyanti pitrutaha. Those who are doing pitrutam, that means ancestor fathers, when they are worshipping, they will go to pitrudevatas only. Yanti bhute bhutani yanti bhuteja. Some people, they will be worshipping the bhutas. Bhutas in the sense of some ghost, some other shaktayam like that, when they worship in unsystematically, they will go to that only. So, bhutani yanti bhuteja yanti madhyapivopimam. One who prays me only, definitely they will reach me. So, he is classifying one who prays in whatever nature, they will go to that deity only according to their nature. So, you have to keep it in mind that always try to pray me within yourself. That is the main thing I want. If you do outside, your fate will be outside only. You will be facing birth and death's trouble. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhakya prayachati tadaham bhakya vahartam asnami prayatatmanaha. Here also you please hear carefully what Paramatma is saying, what now the world is thinking. Here, patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhakya prayachati. Whether it is leaves or flowers or water, whatever they offer, if they offer with utmost devotion, I will take it with affection. Here, offering where, till now, Paramatma is telling that you don't leave me. Ananyachintayam tomam, you have to pray within yourself. But what about this patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam? What are all these? These are all outside only. When you do worship within, how can you worship with these external things? That is the thing you have to know. Here, every person in this world is misunderstood. That in this lokam, patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam, all these are outside materials only, but you have to pray me within me. How can you pray me with these external material things? There must be some deep meaning in this. In this, our Gurudev used to mention, Vyate Veshe Patramstadha Dharma Dharma Supushpascha Sukadukka Falodayaha. This is the underlying meaning. That is Dharma Dharma Veshe Patramstadha Vishas. Vishas means Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasagandhas. That means the five sensory objects. When you keep your mind inside by doing yoga sadhana, naturally your senses they will be detached from the sensory objects. So the dividing the sensory objects are called the leaves, offering of leaves to God. That is Vashe Patramas Tadha Dharma Dharma Supushpascha. The flowers are not the flowers. Simply you pluck away the flowers and leaves. What all I created, you are plucking away the my own flowers and offering to me. This is of no use at all. That is what he means, is that you have to keep your mind in me. Like this, Veshe Patramstana Dharma Dharma Supushpascha. The flowers are dualities, that is the dharma and adharma. According to the worldly affairs, we decide that this is dharma and this is adharma, this is satyam, this is asatyam, and this is justice, this is injustice, and like that we are decided. But all these, whether it is good or bad, positive or negative, all these have to be dedicated to me by keeping your mind within me. Dharma dharmo supushpascha sukha dukkha phalodayaha. What are the flowers? What are the fruits? The fruits are not the fruit that is given by me. These are the fruits not given by me. You have to give your own mind. These are the sukha dukkha phalodayaha. The pain and pleasure you have to dedicate to me. The pain and the pleasure. The pain and pleasure and the dharma, dharma and all these sensory objects are now with your mind, external mind. So if you get devoid of all these things, you can only keep your mind inside me. How to keep? By taking your life force. So always keep it in mind that wherever Paramatma says that you have to keep your mind, means you have to keep your life force also. You have to keep your life force means by doing yoga sadhana. By doing yoga sadhana only, you can keep your mind dividing all these patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam. Phalam, toyam is what Paramatma means is least possible.